Hi everyone! Today let's talk about my primary school experiences in Japan. So in my primary school years, I was really, really lucky enough to be able to go to Japan and experience the primary school or elementary school there for around 1 month. So my mom sent me there so I could experience a little bit of what Japanese school life is like. And there was, I realized that there were so many different aspects of Japanese school life compared to school life that I was used to back in Australia. One of them was that shoes worn inside school isn't the same as the shoes you come to school with. Does that make sense? I think, yeah. Well, so in Japan, school shoes, well, shoes you wear inside the school is different to the shoes you use to go to school. So say you get out of your house with your sneakers on and you get to school walking in those sneakers. When you get to school, you have to take those sneakers off and you have to wear these shoes that you wear inside the school, which are called urabaki. And so they're like small white based shoes that you can buy at any kind of supermarket, and they're usually around 400 to 1000 yen, I think. Those you have to buy before you start school. And so in Japanese primary schools, you wear that urabaki inside the inside the school itself. But when you go to the toilet, you change your shoes into slippers that are used specifically for the toilet. So there's slippers inside the toilets where you have to take off, so where you have to use them when you go to the toilet. Which is really fascinating, right? Because back in Australia, I remember you wear your shoes everywhere. So when you get out of the house, you wear your sneakers. Well, I wore sneakers to my primary school. So you wear your sneakers and you get to school, and then when you get to school, there's no need for you to change shoes, and you just head to your classroom, you sit on your desk. When you want to go to the bathroom, you just go to the bathroom with those shoes on, which was what I was used to. Another thing is that they use these specific bags called randoseru. I think some of you who watch anime may know, but it's like a bag that's like, it's like shaped like this, and I think most of it is made out of leather, but nowadays they have ones that are made out of synthetic leather. And so everyone uses these bags when they go to primary school, and I haven't really heard of them saying that they use it when they go to high school. I think it's just for primary school kids that they use them. It was really I found that bag really cute, and so I got a secondhand randoseru from my close family friends, which I used when I went to the school there. And yeah, it's really cool because that bag is made so that all your books and your notebooks, your textbooks and notebooks fit like just right into that bag. I felt that it was a little bit heavy. I don't know, my one was a little bit of an older version, so because it was secondhand, it wasn't really like a totally new randoseru. But nonetheless, it's really cute, and all your books, textbooks, and your pencil cases fit like just right into that bag. So I thought that was really awesome. Now they have like so many different colors, like pink and purple, and even for blue, they have like different kinds of blue, like, you know, pastel blue, what else, like dark blue. So the bags are so much more cuter now, and now they have like these like little designs printed on them. It's really cute. If you guys ever come to Japan, it'll be cool if you could check those out. It's really awesome. I wish I had those back when I was in Australia, because in Australia, people don't use that specific randoseru bag. They use any kind of bag. So people can be using bags of cartoon characters, or they could just be using normal backpacks. But I know that the randosels are pretty expensive compared to the normal backpacks you can buy at supermarkets. But yeah, sometimes I see people from overseas wearing those randosels as fashion. Another one that I wanted to talk to you about is how girls sit in primary schools. So I've only been to a Japanese primary school. I haven't actually been to a Japanese high school, but what I experienced was that for schools in Japan, girls aren't allowed to cross their feet and sit. So for me, back in Australia, all everyone, every single student was told that you needed to cross your feet when you sit because I think that's like better for your back, or well, they told me that it was better for your back or it helps you sit for longer. And so I was used to sitting with my legs crossed, but when I was sitting with my legs crossed in the school hall in a Japanese primary school, one of the students told me that it wasn't really good manners to sit with your legs crossed in Japan. For girls, you had to sit with your knees tucked inside your hand. And so I was sitting listening to what the principal was saying in the school hall with my legs tucked within my hands. But it was for me, maybe because I wasn't really used to it, but yeah, my bottom hurt a little bit when I was sitting down for around 30 minutes, 1 hour. And one thing that bothered me though was I was wearing skirts to primary schools, and when I was told that it wasn't really good manners to sit with your legs crossed, I was trying to sit with my legs tucked within my hands. But yeah, I was really nervous whether my undies were showing or not. Anyhow, so that's what I wanted to talk to you guys about today. There's so much more that I want to talk to you guys about. So we'll be talking more about school lunches in Japan in the next video. So please look forward to that. I hope you enjoyed it today, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!